pimping.
Here's the thing. In this world, it's either pimp or be pimped.
Yeah.
So if we can arm guys with the tools.
What is that, dog? That's what I'm saying. Your views are very black and white. You're too old to be thinking like this.
Amen. Well, we can have different world views, but if we look at it, it's pimp or be pimp, baby. So I'd rather equip the guys with the tools so they can go out there and navigate the dating marketplace in a way where they won't get finessed.
You don't think that's a dangerous mindset for the world to have?
Did I pimp my wife?
Yeah.
Is that what happened?
Yeah. Or hey, is she pimping you? Same with all of us. But like, not for real. Like, what if we're also telling you that that's not the experience? And that maybe there's experiences you've had and being in a fucked up dating scene like Miami, right? And we know it could get wild, especially if you're going to like these types of parties. You got a lot of girls that are like literally paid to be there. And they might be paid to do other stuff as well. So if you're interacting with these girls, I can understand how you like grow a little bit of fucking resentment. You're like, what? Where are the good girls at?
There's no resentment, man. It's just awareness. And I know it might come off that way, but it's just merely just being aware of what's going on, adapting to the situation, and making the best move that's gonna not put you in a compromising position. Because we've heard so many terrible stories from guys making mistakes, etc., with women. That's come back and really bit them in the ass. So we just want guys to maneuver it.
Yeah.
In a way where
I think that's altruistic of you.
Yeah.
Like I really do. Like you're like, I want you to be safe. I want you to be protected. Like I'm going shark diving. You're like, bro, can I give you this fucking metal suit that you put on? So just in case the shark does bite you, you're looking out.
Yeah.
You're actually looking out for these people. You care. My feeling is that you have a little bit skewed version. If you think it's pimp or be pimped, it's like, bro, you don't like, how can you develop a loving relationship with somebody if you're constantly going, am I pimping or is she pimping? That's dangerous.
Here's the thing. One person in the relationship, whoever cares less, has the leverage. And we want the guy to always care less. We want the man to always have the leverage.
Childish as fuck.
And you guys might not like hearing that.
Childish.
But we truly feel.
I'm not. These aren't new beliefs, bro. You're not telling me some shit none of us have ever heard. We all heard this from fraternity guys in college. I'm saying there's room in your, and I don't have a problem with a lot of the stuff you say. I just think there is room for growth. And you guys' refusal to acknowledge it almost kind of proves it to me, confirms it to me that you guys are not willing to grow right now. And that's fine. That's some ego shit. We're just saying there's room for growth. A very mature answer is, yeah, probably. If you say that to me, I'm sure I got room to grow. Y'all are literally saying, nah, we know how it is. We're in Miami. I bet if you go to Idaho and see only two bitches are getting flown out of Idaho, you'd be like, oh, the world isn't like this. We're just asking you to look and take an assessment of what you say and what you spread and be like, okay, maybe there's room for growth. And y'all aren't even willing to do that for an hour and a half.
I mean, I truly feel that.
That's your opinion, bro.
Yeah, that's your opinion.
See what I'm saying?
I don't care. You guys have a platform. You say whatever you want.
With men and women, one party always one party cares less than the other does, and whoever cares less has the leverage. And we want the guys to always be in a position where the woman is constantly chasing them, not the other way around.
I think you're saying like
the man has to be in a leadership role where the woman feels how do I say that she got the prize. The man has to be in that position, not the woman.
I think we both want to feel like we got the prize, though. And I think that's the best relationship. Yeah. It's like the best sale or the best business move is like you do something where you feel like you got the best and they feel like they got the best, right? Like that's the perfect deal that's made.
It's perfect, but it doesn't happen like that all the
time. I'm not saying it does. And I think that like to act as if one person doesn't like the other person more, for us to sit here and be like, no, every relationship, they equally love. Not. I think that love can be different. And I don't think that there's a scale that you can judge it. But I think that we would get pushback to be like, no, every single one is perfectly equal.
Yeah.
I think that'd be...
Our biggest thing is we want the woman chasing the man's validation, never the other way around, the relationship to be in the best position, because men lead, women follow. It's always been that way. And we want the guys to have the leverage in the relationship, because if you do, your girl's always going to feel like she has the best option that she can get. That's just the way women mate select. They want the best and the brightest. And for her to feel that way, she needs to constantly be chasing for your validation. Baby. And I know you guys might not necessarily agree with that.
Okay, first of all, I want to say, like, Akash and Alex are obviously upset and they feel personally attacked and need to defend their women. Andrew has no stake in this game because white women are the quote-unquote prettiest. So he doesn't have to worry about them. And he doesn't need to feel defensive. That's why he can play good cop. Fresh and fit are hurt and wounded men who won't admit it, which we'll learn in just a second here. And then the irony of it, of course, is that like, it's like a, look. I'm so tired. I just want a burrito or a burger. Listen, when I say this, I mean this. Yes, there are people who you will date and marry via contract. There will be people who want your money, and there are people who are shallow, and there will be people like Myron who can't be trusted. Yeah. And then there are people like my parents and my grandparents and the people I see around me and my best friend's mother and father who've all been together 30, 40, 50, 60 years. And there's no infidelity that we know of. There's no... When they love each other, guys, I'm going to cry. Like, my parents are so in love. Like, they just want to be together all the time. They work together. They raise their kids together. When it came to, like, the kids or the parents, my parents chose each other, and I loved that growing up because they were right. We were going to leave and ditch them, and they deserve to be with each other and to love each other and to look at each other and to see each other. Even with their disagreements, they were so, minuscule and small, but they really love each other, and they're going to be together and do whatever it takes. They're going to fight the world for each other, but Myron, he fights the spouse for the world. The world is not the joy. Existing, you as an individual against existence, everything that you come in contact with, like your spouse in a really, my personal ideal situation is that it's us against the world. Because fuck the world, bro. Who gives a fuck about the world, you know? And so when I hear these men talk, what I'm hearing is that they want to fight the world against their partner. It's so sad. And I understand hurt people, and like this is the bubble they know and this is what they know, but it's just so sad. It's just so sad. Oh my God. Thank you, Destiny, for the super chat. Thank you, girl. I will get that burrito. I will get that. Honestly, I'm feeling pretty good. I know I'm past a contagious stage of my health, so now it's just like the residual breathing issues. So I think I might just get me a burger after this, looking cute as hell, girl. Maybe I'll find me a cowboy cowgirl while I'm out and about. But like legit, I need to go to like a mom and pop shop and just watch people be in love. I live in such a small town. When you go out to dinner, it's just tables of families. Like just like hundreds of tables of families, like husbands and wives and grandparents and aunts and uncles and children. And they're all just like having fun and loving each other. And yeah, they're not in shape as much as they could be, but they're so beautiful people who are just like, they're so wholesome. And I'm so lucky that I grew up around enough bubbles and traveled enough to see that there is so much love in the world that, and when they talk about their partners, they say, I'm so lucky to have them. I am so grateful that they chose me. And instead, this guy is saying that this woman should be hanging around with an insecurity complex because she could lose her great man. Keep him. Nobody wants him.
That's fine. But It's basic, human psychology.
That's how you get cheated on, bro. That's how you get cheated on because you got a girl chasing validation she's never getting, and all of a sudden a dude pulls up on her and he's like, man, you're amazing. I want to give you...
Andrew has gotten pussy, bro. Andrew gets box. Andrew can have my box. I'll do it right now, Andrew. I will sleep with you right now. I will sleep with Akash. I'll have a threesome. I'll have a foursome. I'll have a fivesome with you and your wives. Like this, that's a... Yeah.
You all the validation.
I'm not saying ignore your girl, but what I am saying is that she needs to understand that you are the prize.
And you can also think she is one.
Yeah.
Yes.
She doesn't have to know it, though. That's what I'm saying, bro. She don't got to know it.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, yeah.
Can you clarify that maybe that's more so in the beginning of a relationship to get to that point and then you develop something that's a little real in the beginning? It is a hunt and it is.
Have you guys had long term relationships?
How
long?
Okay,
go ahead. So hold on, just to answer that question as well, because like at the very beginning stage, you're trying to figure out who she is and she wants to figure out who you are. So you can't really be like simping over her too much, because then it's like, okay, this guy is probably gonna be like pandering to me at all times. You gotta like understand who she really is. Once you know that, cool. Now the dynamic changes in that aspect, but you can't just jump into it like, oh yeah, just like love me. Like, no, you gotta see who she really is.
I can imagine the beginning, but then once the relationship
connection. Like you guys have to build something together.
You build a connection, but like for me personally, the way I do it is I just have other girls. Like whoever I'm dealing with, she knows I'm not gonna be monogamous.
That's helpful.
And actually what that does is it keeps her on her toes. Women always get in line when they know you have other women in line. It's
women get in line. Why do people talk this way about people they love? Like get in line. I hate that shit.
Just the way it is. You know what I'm saying? When you have other girls, women are on their best behavior. You know, and I know that's an unflattering...
Women are on their best behavior. They're not dogs. There may be bitches sometimes, but they're not dogs.
Thing to say on podcast.
It's not necessarily wrong. It's not necessarily wrong, especially if you're being transparent. Like, if she's building towards something, I think she'd probably agree. I assume most girls, when they start dating a guy, especially a guy with value, they're like, there are other girls that are probably interested in this guy, and maybe he's dating. I know it comes across harsh when you say it, but I don't think it's actually unrealistic. I think it is actually the reality. But eventually, if you want to have a relationship, you're going to have to put your focus and time and love into that one person. And if you keep playing like the cat and mouse game, it's going to get exhausting for her, man. And she's gonna go to security. We all go to emotional security. And if you're not her emotional security, it's going to be something else. And I think that's why those pickup artist dudes flamed out, is because they realized the skills that they used to get the girls were not the skills that they used to maintain them.
Shallow.
So it's like, what's that?
It's shallow.
It's shallow, right? And it's just exhausting, and you're actually not building something real, and you're keeping this person in a state of perpetual fear, and you're doing that because you're in a state of perpetual fear, so nobody's comfortable. Eventually, you both need to let the guard down and be like, listen, are we in this together? Are we going to build this? And we can argue about human nature all we want, but like, marriage is an institution, be it religion or not, that has existed for a long time. I'm literally rolling the dice on it. I'm gambling that I can build something with it. I saw my parents do it. You know what I mean? I've seen other people do it, and I've seen it flounder as well. But to act like it's not a possibility. And
nobody's marriage is invincible. None of us are saying 100%. Our marriage is invincible.
Sorry, I was talking. Sorry, people in the chat are confused if they're blocked. You're not blocked. I see your comment. And then people said, I can't hear you. I was talking to my brother who came into the room, so I muted myself so I could talk to him. So that might be what you guys were seeing, but I'm now, you guys should be able to hear my audio.
And we're all going to fuck up, and we're all going to say things that are disrespectful, and we're all going to be treated a certain way by our partners that we can't fathom they would actually do. But ideally, you're committed enough to build back from that and restore that thing that you guys are building together. That's my only fear. My fear is that if you keep on playing this game, where you're like, I got to keep her a little bit away, I can't keep her comfortable, I can't let her feel secure, you're not going to actually feel that love from a woman when she is secure. And that's a powerful thing, man. When a woman feels secure, bro.
I respectfully disagree a little bit. I'm going to say, like, you know, I always say you don't want a girl comfortable. You know, future, bitches don't get too comfortable. Like, comfortable. You know, because when they're uncomfortable. But here's the thing.
He got seven baby mamas.
I'm just using that as a quote. But in general, like, you know, when a girl isn't necessarily, when she doesn't know where she stands with you, and there might be other women, you know, in the wing, that's when they're on their best behavior, man. It is what it is. I mean, like,
you think that's sustainable? Look, early on, playing games, I get, dude, none of us are fucking idiots. No, you're being up front.
You let her know.
We get
it.
Early on, yeah, whatever. Being up front, talking to other women, so you don't get too emotionally invested because you might get hurt early on because you're both scared. That makes absolute sense. If you're telling.
Okay, just for the record of how I date, like, I, let's say I talk to someone. So until you meet my family, we're not a boyfriend and girlfriend. We're not a couple. We are not even thinking about being like, you can talk about me on the internet if you want, but I am not your girlfriend. Until you meet my family, which is different than how I dated before, but now I'm realizing it's much better. And to meet my family means you're about to see a side of me that's very private, because I don't share my family on the internet. Only one or two of my siblings ever shows up on the internet, and I've got 10 or 9 siblings. So for me, meeting my family is like a huge like trust thing. I'm not a normal person. I can't just date like normal people. My family's not on the internet. They like to be private. So the way I date is that until we are a couple, I don't expect you to be monogamous. I don't expect you to not date other people. I don't expect you not to break up. Like, you know, if you want to break up with me during that dating, that's fine. It's not even like, it's all fair. Like, all of it is fair. Until we are a couple, until we are like talking about getting married in a real way, because like that's what I'm dating for right now. So to be clear, I am only dating to get married. I'm not interested in anything casual or short term. I mean, I'm an open person and all that stuff, and I'm open to like connecting with people temporarily, sure, but like not casually, like friends maybe. Like, I do have sex with my friends, which is probably, I mean, it's been a while since the COVID, right, and everything. But also, like, in the past, it's worked out because those are like sex positive people. Like, they don't expect to date you just because you had sex. So it's just like, do you know what I'm saying? Like, it's not, for me, it's all about what's happening in the moment. Like, hey, what do you want to do? would you like to date me? Would you like to be like monogamous? Like, I expect you to go out and date people until we are officially a couple, which would not be a surprise. It would be talked about and negotiated. Even marriage, no surprise proposals. Hi, would you like to get married to me? Sure, let's talk about that. Oh, and if you spend over $1,000 on a ring, I will think like ill of you. Like, spending money on a ring makes no sense. I'm going to lose that bitch. So like, I'm a very, like, I feel like my standard is high when it comes to values, but my expectation of like what other girls are expecting is so low in comparison. I don't need a diamond ring. I don't even need a wedding ring. Like, by me, I don't give a fuck. Like, my parents barely even wear theirs because they lose them all the time, or they're always doing stuff in the garden. Like, you know what I'm saying? It's just not reasonable. I work, like, I want to live on a farm. Like, I don't give a fuck if I'm wearing a ring. What I care about is if we are in love, we have the same values, and if we believe in the same, like, future that we're trying to build together. You know what I mean? And then to stay on top of it, you know? If you're feeling like not seen in the relationship, talk to me. If you have a different love language than I do, let's talk about that. It's just like, you know what I'm saying? There are so many ways to view relationships, but obviously the way these men are viewing their relationships is just, obviously they didn't have good examples growing up. I'm sorry, you cannot watch people, and maybe you can. Sneeko did this, or I think Sneeko's parents are still together, right? But he doesn't want to be monogamous and he wants to sleep around. I think Sneeko's really going to grow up, though. I think he's just young and hot, and so he's a fuckboy. But I think his introspection level is so high that give him like 5 or so years and he's going to settle into his skin and feel much more comfortable. And I think he'll be very happy. And I think that's like, you know what I mean? I don't think he's going to be that fuck boy for the rest of his life. But, you know, these guys, I think they're too old at this point that they would have to, like, change their whole platform. And that, and the fear of that is, like, because their beliefs are tied into their money, they might not be able to publicly change their minds. Because I know when I was in talk radio, one of the things they told me as a conservative is that if I'm going to be a lesbian conservative, I can't ever be bisexual. And at the time, I knew I was attracted to both. I just didn't know how to, like, cope with it. So I said, you know, I can't do this. I can't be a different person online than I am in my personal life. But a lot of people are, so.
If you're going to get on this podcast and say, I'm going to get married and my wife is going to know it's an open relationship, I have a hard time believing this. It's open for me. You are going to be loyal
absolutely
to me.
I'm going
to
do that.
Yeah, okay.
Millionaires are like that, though, in the world?
I grew up Muslim, so, you know,
there's many millionaires.
Oh, you got the religious loophole where we just get, you know, yeah. God is on our side. And yeah. You say you grew up Muslim or you are Muslim?
I am, but yeah.
Okay. Practicing.
So, yeah, well, no, I need to get back on it. You know,
so
I'm not
practice
praying
when it's convenient. I got you.
Yeah, but yeah.
So I'm Muslim for multiple wives. Right? Bali bacon and breakfast.
Let me get back on it. I'm gonna hit the mosque. But no.
I appreciate that because I meet a lot of religious men who are only religious when it's convenient to them, which is religion's such a fucking joke.
Oh, just in general, like I've always had that worldview that like a man can have multiple women, but not the other way around. Men and women are not the same whatsoever when it comes.
I don't
to
think that we would disagree with you on that. Like, I don't think women want that. I don't think there's women out there like, I definitely want multiple men.
I agree with you on that.
And I think there's probably guys who for sure would be like, man, it'd be nice to have multiple women. But can I build the thing that I want with multiple women? I don't know. I don't think so.
I believe in polyamory and open relationships, so I know it's possible, but you have to be a very specific kind of person. And even I'm not that person. I don't have the emotional spoons to be poly anymore, but I do, and I have seen it done.
I think you can. It's just hard.
It's hard.
Because you're going to be managing multiple women. You're going to be managing.
And poly's equal. So everyone, it's not gendered like this. And if it is, I don't trust it.
You know, so it takes a very strong leader to be able to do it. But you could definitely do it.
But see, this is what you tell guys. Hey, here's your tools. You choose your choice. It's your life to live. Marriage, no marriage, multiple women, your choice to make. That's it.
Guys.
Chance, you said it. Fresh and Fumble are trying to avoid commitment while guaranteeing commitment from women.
Thank you for coming up here. I thought we were gonna convert you. I thought we were gonna convert you into.
I spent honesty, man.
Yeah.
I appreciate you guys coming up here, and I'm curious about your journey.
City Boys for life.
We'll see. I don't know. I think a girl is gonna get you. I think you're gonna get locked down.
Is City Boys for life mean like partiers for life, like pussy for life? Because if that's the case, then like. Then they're just fuckboys, and that's fair. You're allowed to be a fuckboy. You're allowed to teach people how to be fuckboys. Cass says, if so, you're not dating until they meet your fam. Well, we're dating, like recording, like we're going out. But if they want to be monogamous before then, would you be willing to compromise? Yeah, because I don't So Brittany, my brain, once I'm in a relationship, like even dating to check them out, my brain can't focus on other people. So I wouldn't be going around anyways, but I don't need to hold them to my standard either. So if they want to be monogamous while we're just getting to know each other, I'm fine with that because that's how I default anyways, because I don't have the emotional spoons to like date this person and date this person at the same time. Like that's never going to happen. My brain cannot do that. So I just wouldn't put it on them. Like if they were like, hey, I want to date other people while we're dating, I'm like, okay. Like, that's cool. I don't see a problem with that because we have no commitment yet. We're just dating. You know what I mean? Like, we're not partnered. We're not like, you haven't met my family. Like, why are we acting like this is serious yet? It's not serious till it's serious.
And I hope that, I really hope that you allow that to happen. And I hope if you find a girl and that she means that much to you guys.
In Colombia.
They'll do it. And it might be in Colombia. It might be.
I'll find her.
In Miami.
But I'm going to get three more for two.
There you go.
I just hope you guys grow up a little bit because the way you do view the world is very immature. But
that's your opinion.
It comes with life. It is my opinion. But yeah. I just hope you guys grow up. Because it's like this part of the messages that you are teaching your listeners, it's not good for society.
Part of it's really valuable.
Some.
Not all of it.
Yeah.
Yes, I agree with that. I agree. Yeah, I agree with that.
I mean, we can agree to disagree, which is totally cool. No problem. You know, I mean, if you guys have your 100% views on our content being immature.
You totally guys have cool. to get married. Yeah. And that is the end all
one,
deal.
At one point.
What did she do to you, bro?
I knew it.
See?
I knew one of y'all was married.
What did she do to you, bro?
I knew one of y'all was married.
And you was never hurt.
And you never in a long-term relationship?
Like with marriage?
No, just like a long, like a multiple year girlfriend type of thing.
You know, with other girls.
But it was never exclusive.
No. That's stupid. Exclusivity.
It might be stupid, but if you haven't experienced it, then it's hard for you to say if it's good or bad, right?
I genuinely believe as a man, if you get to a certain point, it is not in your best interest to be monogamous.
But you've never tried it and it's never worked for you, so it's hard.
No, right? I've done it with like one girl that I'm like, this is not fun. I'm just like,
but maybe she wasn't the right one.
Nah, man. It, because I've always said like one woman can never sexually satisfy you. Like a man's, like...
I'm going to be real, boo-boo. You've never fucked me. I have never been with a man that did not complain I wanted sex too much. I've never been with a man that didn't say, holy shit, you're wearing me out. And I've never been with a man who didn't tell me, like, you want sex way too much.
A man's sexual thirst is, like, almost insatiable. Like, he's going to want variety. Like, guys always want variety.
Wait till you're late 30s. You know what I'm saying?
They want variety. So it's like, she could, you know, handle your emotional needs as a woman. But by herself, sexually, no. You're always going to want other women. Men like different colors and flavors. It is what it is.
What you guys are talking about is evolutionary. None of us can deny that.
Why do these men think I stay in shape? Why do you think I do my Kegel exercises? Why do you think I do pull? Why do you think I do push-ups? Why do you think I ride my bed and practice? Because as I get older, women, as we age, our sex drive goes up, boo-boo. That's why we want to fuck young guys, because they can keep up with us. These men, they can't keep up with us. I've never been with a man, older or younger, who could keep up with me. And I am waiting to find that man, because I am not convinced.
That evolution is hardwired in every species, that the man is sperm is very cheap genetically. So you try to fuck everything and procreate as much as possible.
For sure,
it's hardwired in us. What you are also overlooking is that in humanity, we decided to stay monogamous for reproductive success. Because at the end of the day, we need the kid to stay alive. And the best way for us to do that is monogamy. So if you're going to talk about evolution, monogamy is also evolutionary.
That is true.
Yeah, but polygamy works as well. It works great for the family because you have multiple women. And then, you know, they all care for the children collectively.
If it worked, every culture would adopt it.
Most men
there's a reason
can't,
why men don't
can't do it. They can't That's do it. They want because to, it doesn't can't. Work. No, they don't have to.
Financial.
Literally, I'm not even fucking with you. These people live in such a bubble. Go to Seattle. You know how many girls I know who have like 4 boyfriends? A lot. You know how many people I know who have like multiple partners?
Values
and means.
For
it.
Sure.
That's
for sure.
Why.
I guess what I'm trying to say is that it makes sense what you're teaching because we teach what we know. And we teach what we're experts in. And you're an expert in this lifestyle, whether that's by choice, which you say, or by just not having the experience where you've been in a relationship that's like a loving, beautiful relationship that you want to build, right? You're teaching the thing you know. But you do acknowledge that there are other things out there. You at least know it.
Yeah,
for sure.
And they could also be, quote unquote, right and possible, and that there's a way to teach that as well. And all I would say is like, maybe keep your mind open because you might find that. And then you might want to share that with all the people who really fuck with you and they like what you teach them, bro.
I know a lot of guys like, you know, would be happy with a monogamous relationship and stuff like that. And they want one girlfriend. But to be honest, man, if you gave the guy the choice, hey, listen, man, you can have 4 girls, you know, and hook up with them, or you can have one girl. Most guys are going to want the 4 girls. It's just that the politically correct thing to say.
Not for marriage.
You want four periods, four mood swings, four, like, you want four women. Like, just think about what you're asking for. I've been in, like, open relationships, poly circles with multiple women, multiple men, bisexual, queer, straight. It doesn't matter. And I'm telling you right now, like, humans are human. We all make mistakes. But what's really, I think, clear is that, like, they do not consider the human experience as an individual. They only see people in groups. So Fresh and Fit could never consider an individual's experience in a true way.
Marriage, dog. Fuck is one that. Girl. Yeah,
four,
you know what
four wives is crazy.
That's why Muslims are suicide bombers. Bro. Extremist. I want out.
Extremist.
No, yeah. We need those
virgins. Yeah. We're doing the thing with the jokes.
Yeah. No, I hear what you're saying. I think what happens a lot of times in relationships is you have to make sacrifices for the things that make you happy. And if that one person be with that one person.
I'm sorry. Darren says, would you go on their Fresh and Fit podcast, Brittany? You could share a completely different perspective from their current crowd. Bring some of your Seattle friends. My Seattle friends couldn't handle it. They're in two bubbles. The problem is most people do live in bubbles. I live outside the bubbles. Obviously, that's my whole channel's premise, is that I don't live in your bubbles. I just observe them and I visit and I hang out and then I live there for a time and then I leave. So the problem with my Seattle friends is, like, they're way too leftist in SJW. They would never be able to handle Fresh and Fit. They'd get triggered, trauma, cry, and leave the show. But the problem is, like, I have no stake in any of these bubbles because I don't live here. So I think I would be helpful to, like, a Fresh and Fit crowd, but not really, because, like, the people themselves aren't willing to grow. They just had men lecture them. They just had their own kind try to help them, and they would not hear it. So, like, what good is a sex working woman gonna do when they're just gonna see me as, like, box and not even fuckable box? Because, like, I don't look like these girls, you know what I mean? So it's like, nah, not worth my investment. But I'm always open to talking. Like, I just don't do a lot of collabs with people because most people they want to debate me, and I don't debate people. I'm not interested in debating my humanity. I will discuss my humanity. I will not debate it.
Person makes you so happy in these aspects of your life, you're maybe willing to sacrifice this other thing, right? And I think as you guys are going to get more famous, and it's going to get even easier to get pussy, and you'll start to realize when it's not something that you're conquesting, when you become the conquested, that pussy shit means nothing.
Actually, no, of course.
I'm just
harder.
Saying, like, you guys aren't there yet. When you're there, when you start being the one that's hunted, when they start you know what I mean? Like, when they start putting the notch, when they put the notch in your belt, all of a sudden you're like, oh shit, I'm the gazelle,
bro.
You know what I'm saying? You need to be defensive then.
It was easier before this, bro. We got more girls back.
That's because all your clips of you is you yelling at 10 women, bro. When the shit with y'all starts popping off,
dude, girls are coming, but it's like, I don't want, like, it's, for example, like, they're coming, but I don't want you. It's like, before I was hunting what I wanted.
Right.
I was like, stay away, I don't want you. That's the problem. So it's like, I got to pick and choose and be careful. What do you want? Da, da, da. So
we got way more girls before the show, man. Way more, bro. Way more. Because we had more time.
Yeah.
We do two shows a day. They're live. We're dealing with a bunch of crazy girls.
We don't travel
girls.
Like that.
Girls find our social media. You guys are those misogynists for the podcast. Like, oh, okay, here we go. All right, cool. Move on to the next one. So it's like, we actually get less girls now because of, you know, the fame, so to speak. If they were going to call it fame.
It's hard before. Now.
You know, it is what it is.
I'm checking in on y'all in 3 years.
Mm-hmm. Let's all do it.
Yep.
I'll have three wives.
Can I ask you one last question before we go? Being black, being a little bit self-loathing, is that why you wanted to enter law enforcement?
Oh, man. Here we go.
Akash is on it today. Okay, we're going to X this out. And now it's just going to be me and you for a second, guys. So, oops, I'm in me sideways. Okay. Hi, what happened to my camera? Hold on. It, like, completely. No, this way. There we go. Okay, so now I'm, like, more on the screen. Okay, you know what's so funny about this? Oh my gosh, that's so funny. He was fun. That was pretty funny. Spring Nino says, I dare you to go on the show. It's not a dare, Homeskill, and I'm not afraid. You should see the shit I've done in BDSM. You think I'm afraid of boys? Like, I'm not afraid of boys that I know, like, I know they won't stab me. I know they won't rape me. So, like, I can't be afraid of them. You know what I mean? Like, literally, this isn't something I'm opposed to. I've done it before. I've done things like this before where I talk to people who are different from me. The thing is like, I don't think they need to change. I don't care about changing their mind. I'm just saying that if they want to know that there's more in life before they die, they might want to explore those bubbles. But if they're happy, then I don't care about changing their minds. Like, I'm not here to change their minds. That's the problem, is, like, they think they're objectively right about the West, and I think they're subjectively right. I think their bubble is the only place they understand how to exist in. And I'm saying, if I, again, my brothers, I'm Middle Eastern too, motherfuckers. I'm just not Muslim. I grew up Catholic. So, like, we don't treat our people like this. Women aren't just, like, ornaments. Women are the mothers of our children. They're honorable. Their wombs carry life. Like, you have to respect them with dignity. You don't cheat or abuse your wives. You know what I mean? I'm sorry you grew up Muslim where, like, women are an object. But, like, that's shitty. That's religion for you. And Catholicism has their own set of bullshit, too, for sure. But, like, at least my lineage modernized. Do you know what I'm saying? So, like, my dad would also think they were losers. So the point is, like, me going on their show, like, what am I supposed to do? Hi, do you know you can live a different way? Yeah, like, fresh, like, Andrew just told him this. Also, I know not all Muslims are like this. I know. But obviously, it's like the specific kind of Muslims like we've been seeing in the media lately who are talking about women shouldn't just get divorced and women are the problems and women are this. It's like, I'm so tired. Aren't you tired of blaming women for your problems? It's like women, like feminists will blame men for everything, but then they'll call them stupid. And these men will call women stupid and blame them for everything. So are you all telling me you are being convinced by stupid people to like ruin your lives? Because that's all I'm hearing. Fuck the gender binary or whatever. Are you all saying men and women are literally so stupid and yet have managed to commandeer the courts and take over through the patriarchy and do all this bullshit? I'm just confused. Are women stupid or are they smart? Are men are stupid or are they smart? At the end of the day, is it not just individuals who are collectively together? I'm exhausted. I have to eat something. I just need to put something in my mouth that is dead and can't come back to annoy me by talking.